If you want to unlock what is arguably one devastatingly powerful, sick-looking, double-barrel shotgun for Battlefield 1, you've come to the right place. In this quick video, as with all my weapon unlock videos, we're going to jump straight into the details and I will share my tips to help you unlock both the Model 1900 Factory and the Model 1900 Slug variants as quickly as possible. Although some weapon unlock assignments can be quite difficult to complete, you should find this challenge fairly easy, especially if you use these quick tips I have for you. If you aren't familiar with the Model 1900, it is a double barrel shotgun and it is one of the new weapons added to Battlefield 1 with the in the name of the Tsar Russian DLC. After getting my hands on this weapon during CTE gameplay, I was blown away by just how well balanced and devastating this new shotgun is. Ever since I saw this double barrel shotgun in action on the in the name of the Tsar pre-release trailer, I knew a shotgun loving Battlefield veteran such as myself just had to unlock this thing and add it to my Battlefield 1 weapons arsenal. The Model 1900 was a cheaper version of the preceding Model 1894 break action double barrel shotgun. The term break action means that the gun's barrel, or in this case side-by-side double barrels, are affixed to a hinge that breaks open for loading and unloading. This break action reloading animation gives this powerful new shotgun one aggressive looking and one aggressive sounding reload. The first variant we will quickly discuss unlocking tips for is the Model 1900 Factory version. The Model 1900 Factory double barrel shotgun can be quite fun to use if you keep two things in mind. One, you only have two bullets to expend, so make them count. And two, the reload of this shotgun, albeit very cool to watch, can take approximately 2.4 seconds when empty and 3.2 seconds if you have one round left to expend. That being said, since the majority of the use of this Model 1900 Factory will probably be in close range, keep that reload time and low bullet count in mind. Always be prepared to dodge, duck, or dive away from those nearby enemies while you wait for the reload animation to complete. To unlock the Model 1900 Factory version, you must first have the In the Name of the Tsar DLC. I know I shouldn't have to say this, but often there are new or casual players who are not aware of this subtle but very important detail. Then you must perform 40 kills with the M97 trench gun, backboard, and in one round, that's one round, perform 5 kills with anti-tank rockets. The easy part of this weapon assignment is the 40 kills with the M97 trench gun backboard variant. The M97 trench gun is a pump action 12 gauge shotgun, and the backboard variant decreases the weapon's recoil, thereby making follow up shots easier to hit. The best game mode I've found to get the M97 trench gun backboard kills quickly would either be Team Deathmatch or Domination. Team Deathmatch and Domination are the best modes in my opinion for using this shotgun because of the close proximity of enemies at all times and the quick respawn rate. You want to accumulate the kill count with this weapon as quickly as possible, so larger maps with more distant enemies really won't be of much assistance when time is of the essence. The second and more challenging part of this weapon assignment is the requirement to secure 5 anti-tank kills in one round. Whenever you see a requirement for a number of tasks to do in one round, I always recommend larger game modes such as Operations or Conquest, since these game mode rounds take longer to complete, thereby giving you as much time as possible to complete the assignment. I recommend using the anti-tank rockets to target clusters of enemies, especially in buildings and doorways, and even hit walls or objects near enemies to get secondary kills from anti-tank rocket splash damage. With quick and simple tips, you should unlock the Model 1900 Factory version as quick as possible. Of course, the Factory variant is great for hip firing, close quarters room clearing, and surprising enemies close by, but what happens when you want to engage enemies at both close range and effectively as well at distance? That's right, you unlock the Model 1900 Slug variant. The Model 1900 Slug variant uses slugs as its ammunition type versus the buckshot ammunition of the Factory variant. The Model 1900 Slug variant is more powerful than the Model 1900 Factory, so don't be surprised to one-hit close enemies even with the slug rounds equipped. Where the Model 1900 Slug rounds shine, though, is its ability to effectively down enemies at great distance. Keep in mind that the accompanying sights aren't the best, so taking that extra second or two to adjust your shot on enemies at distance might prove well worth it. I recommend using 2x zoom when this shotgun is equipped to better adjust your targeting on enemies at distance. In order to unlock the Model 1900 Slug variant, you must again have the In the Name of the Tsar DLC and perform 50 kills with the 12-gauge automatic extended, and perform 20 kills with the Gosser M1870 revolver. In order to complete this assignment, I highly recommend playing Domination, Team Deathmatch, or Close Game modes, where using the 12-gauge automatic extended shotgun or the Gosser pistol will have you as close to the enemy as possible. Both the 12-gauge automatic extended and the Gosser M1870 are excellent close quarters, powerful weapons. The 12-gauge automatic was the first successful semi-automatic shotgun design and has remained in production for nearly a century. Unlike the backboard and hunter variants, the extended version offers 2 more rounds for a total of 7 at the ready per reload. The 12-gauge automatic won't be your most powerful shotgun in Battlefield 1, but keeping enemies close and hip-firing to maintain mobility should net you the 50 kills as quickly as possible. As for the second part of this assignment, 20 kills are needed with the Gosser M1870 revolver. The Gosser M1870 revolver provides high damage and is specific to the assault class only. The Gosser M1870 has one of the slowest rates of fire among the revolvers, but provides very high damage per shot. I found the Gosser able to reliably kill targets in 2 shots up to almost a couple dozen meters away. One note of caution when using this revolver is the reload time is absurd. The Gosser M1870 takes very long to reload, so waiting to fire those last remaining rounds before reloading can keep you alive when in close proximity to the enemy. Take accurate shots with this revolver, play close game modes that I mentioned, and you should reach those 20 required kills in absolutely no time at all. With these tips at your disposal, you should have that Model 1900 factory and Model 1900 slug variant as quickly as possible. If you found this video helpful to you, please rate it because it helps me. Let me know down below what weapon you're interested in me unlocking next. I mean, we've gone through a few of them, so we're almost done unlocking all the new weapons. We are on the road to 2K subscribers, so hit that subscribe button so you don't miss out on any epic gameplay, gaming tips, live stream, and weekly videos I have for you guys. Wait a minute, we've actually hit 2,000 subscribers. This is awesome. Guys, we've hit 2,000 subscribers. I gotta figure out some type of giveaway or something. Maybe we'll give away a couple copies of the In the Name of the Tsar DLC. So you gotta figure that out. I'm looking here, we hit 2,000 subscribers. It's awesome. Glad to have each one of you guys here. It's your boy Rumspanker. Thanks for watching, and until next time, I'm out of here.